Paid their annual visit to the sunny side. And here's one of the largest crop of apples from the old apple tree. These apples, believe it or not, must be 100 years old. Guess who's driving by herself down the street? None other than Helen Healy. September 1991, and our 18-year-old cat, Kitty. It's 6:30 in the morning, and somewhere here, Lynn is passing out campaign literature. Here, Lynn and I are on the Taconic Parkway. It's now October 12th, and we're headed north to visit with Cousin Nellie and her daughter, Maura. They live in Queensbury, which is about 40 miles north of Albany. This is Maura's office. She is a tax accountant and works at home. And now, here is Nellie. She was born in Harborview and came to this country with Maura and her son about 1954.
Nice.
They have the whole,
showed
the whole thing, you know. But I didn't know what it was.
Well, they haven't got up to date since you were a kid, man.
You can say
things
that.
Things have improved.
Well, I can't get over the old picture of the old house. I can't get over that. My God, so dilapidated looking.
I know.
I never seen it in that state before I arrived.
Well, the picture's dilapidated,
yeah,
too.
I think that's mostly.
No, no, but the whole surroundings, like, you know.
So tell me about Uncle Richard when he used to come visit you there. And
you know, all I can ever remember is him coming in, him and the wife.
Mary?
The minute he died, she was thrown out.
The Pope's.
Well, there haven't been so.
This is Maura's husband, Cornelius. Now we're headed home, again on the Taconic State Parkway, one of the prettiest rides to take in the fall. It is now October 16th, 1991, and we're back up at Ellison Avenue to help with the closing of the cottage on the following day. Here is Jack from California to help with the closing. He's trying to lead Abby around on a leash, but I think Abby is leading him. Thank you. The shutters are being put on very securely, as usual. There is no sense of foreboding over the impending storm. Life goes on as usual, not knowing that in a matter of less than 2 weeks, disaster will strike. The Storm and Norman hat, as modeled by Jack Healy. After closing the cottage, Lynn and I returned to Polly Drive and the leaves on the lawn, where Rick was good enough to help us rake them up. Good boy, Rick. Rick will shortly catch sight of me taking his picture. And now it is the weekend before the Halloween of 1991, and Chris and Julie and Scooter and Whitney are down to pick up the pumpkins. That pumpkin weighed 82 pounds. These two pumpkins weigh considerably more. It was Wednesday, October 30th, 1991. After sweeping up the leaves, Lynn and I decided to go down to the harbor. I had heard a report the tide was unusually high. Huntington has three harbors. We went to Centerport Harbor and saw here the highest tide we'd ever seen in the 26 years in Huntington. I really wasn't worried about any real storm because there had been no reports of a northeaster moving up the east coast.